Rocking and rolling.
I got my weed rolling. Start up a fire. Inhale, exhale. Time to get high. As I twist that la 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 la. As I blow.
Every Monday.
There you go. No time. So tell them that thing that they're supposed to do.
Like, share, subscribe.
Yeah, guys. Do that. Do that right there.
Evening, North Korea. Shout out to the Raiders of the Culture Clue, the DJs.
Oh, it's them Smoke Break Boys. Oh, yeah.
What the hell was that? That's you just us. Change everything. That's... Like, from week to week, he just does something different. First, but... he's singing on a what's they call that?
Oh, yeah. Not a Movado. Yeah. Not a Movado. That's a watch.
Yeah, that is a watch. It's a nice looking watch, too, by the way.
But you don't like that one better? We the Smoke Break Boys.
I don't smoke. Stop smoking, ladies and gentlemen. So, wow, that's things that rats do. That's 6'9"-ish of you. That's very 6'9"-ish
of you. I didn't say anything.
I'm
looking at this nice blood that I might smoke.
You're picking up evidence.
Evidence of what? This is not yours. I didn't say this was yours, did I?
Can you please put it down?
Put what down? I think I might like this and smoke this. It looks kind of nice. Like,
shout out to sponsors.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to the sponsors.
Sweet Leafs. Do remember, man. Get that C Smoke Break mix. I promise you, you will not be disappointed.
AC soon?
Yeah, very soon.
AC soon.
Like AC soon. Almost like maybe today's Friday, but y'all gonna see this Monday. Yep. So possibly this Monday. Possibly. Yes. Well, today. It would be today. But it's not us doing it Monday. We actually record it Friday because it takes him at least 3 days to edit. So.
Yeah, I heard it was like huge, like three floors. Like, yeah, I heard it's like
good. Oh, and they're having a block party to open it up, and they said that we have to go out there and be the. What would that be?
Sweet Leafs is a what? Dispensary.
It's a dispensary.
So how are they having a block party? They don't own the whole block.
No,
how
but they block party? Listen, this is what I was told. Shout out to the boy Vic. Shout out to the boy Matt. I was told that they're gonna have a block party. And they want us to do a show from down there.
At a block party.
On a block party.
So they want us to set up on the block.
He's already being negative, ladies and gentlemen. This is why you can't bring all your stuff to people because negativity.
It's still
listen
cold
to me,
outside.
Listen to me carefully,
how
y'all.
We setting just up
listen
outside? To me.
Get these negative people from around you who always shoot down ideas before they even develop.
That's negative.
They always say yes.
Do you like the cold?
No.
Okay, so how we set up?
How do you know we're not doing
cold?
It on a warm day? How do you know it's not going to be a warm day? How do you know they don't pick a warm day? They said it's going to be 60 this week coming up. 60.
That's what they say. They say they also could press the button and it could be 25.
Look,
it's
man,
a button.
It hasn't been a bad winter. Don't complain.
It hasn't been a bad winter at all.
It snowed twice. And one of them, they made it sound like it was...
Don't say that.
No, I'm just saying. It was the end of the world. And guess what? Everybody ran to the supermarket. Supermarkets were empty. And ain't shit happened. Which is a good hustle. Not going to lie to you. It's a good hustle.
It could snow tomorrow. You never know. Don't jinx it. Don't jinx it.
You could be gone tomorrow. That's another thing that we was discussing behind the scenes. People, enjoy this thing called life a little more, y'all. Y'all quick to say, I'll see you tomorrow. And do you know how many people said, I'll see you tomorrow and didn't make it till tomorrow?
That's a fact.
So just... You know, embrace what you're doing now, man. Get that nasty spirit of yours. That's what got you fucked up in life. You know, you always saying, yo, shit don't work for me. It's you. It ain't them. It's you. You always negative. Like these negative people, they always look at they always have a problem for the solution. Every fucking thing. No, bruh. Just try. Give it a shot. Can't means won't. Shout out to Sue. I see you just rolling your doobie right in front. Listen. It is a smoke break on DeathStormRadio.com. You can go right here, tap in, you know, go look around, you know, send the video. I might post it. Never know.
Might.
So here's the one thing that I don't understand, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, boy, here we go.
No, I just want to, I want to get to the bottom of this.
Straight to it.
And again, to all of the sneakerheads out there, shout out to y'all. Doing what you
I
do.
I hope you're going to talk about what I think you're going to talk about.
But $400 for a pair of sneakers that, to me, don't look good. That's just my personal opinion. I have my opinion just like everybody else does. Do you like them? You might like the Trumps. You look like a Trump supporter. You said you was going to vote for him, so you can't lie now. Go back to the old show. You see it. He said he's going to vote for Trump. He said it.
So you're voting for Trump.
You can't even
vote. I like Trump. I love
him. He can't even vote.
Well, I can't vote.
You know, you got to be somewhat in the American system to vote. You're not in the American system. Do you have a Social Security card? Trump, Biden, who you voting for?
Trump.
Trump.
You talking about the Trinidad James looking sneakers?
Yeah. Gold all in my chain. Gold all in my ring.
Gold all in my watch. Don't believe me, just watch. All gold on my feet. All go, that those, yes, those are the ugliest looking sneakers. What is he doing selling sneakers? He doesn't play ball or nothing. What,
he said he said they was gonna sell out. He has 1,000 pairs supposedly that he made. I don't know. I wasn't there.
He will.
But now, if you go to this Fox thing that they showed, they kind of disrespecting the culture. They saying that he's making sneakers because that would make the sneaker people go and, you know, get with him and vote for him because that's how they got to get to us. That's how low we think. That's what they, look, go look at it. It's right here.
If you want to know what Trump campaign staffers think about you, just watch Fox News, like this weekend when they gushed over Donald Trump's new ploy for money, a limited edition series of gaudy gold $400 Trump sneakers. And like they always do on Fox, somebody said the quiet part out loud on what the big sneaker strategy is really all about.
Even the sneaker thing. I was on social media last night. Very interesting. As you see black support eroding from Joe Biden, this is connecting with black America because they love sneakers. They're into sneakers. They love the, you know, this is a big deal, certainly in the inner city. So when you have Trump roll out his sneaker line, they're like, wait a minute, this is cool. He's reaching them on a level that defies and is above politics. The culture always trumps politics. And Trump understands culture like no politician I've ever seen.
Seriously?
If he was doing it for the sneakerheads, he should have made a better sneaker. Those look like...
they're not a good-looking sneaker.
Those look like bootleg Christian Louboutins.
Louboutins is kind of ill.
They look like...
The flag on there. I'm trying to understand the flag. What was the flag about?
What's the gold about?
There's been gold sneakers before. They have been. I don't know about that much gold, but he's a little goldish. Like his what do you consider his complexion? What would he go under orange, as far as complexion?
Orange. He's orange.
Okay.
He's part of the orange people.
For the orange route.
I've never seen that.
And being that we're talking about, you know, that, did you see Tiffany Haddish? That's her name? I don't even know
her name. That's her name.
Okay.
That's her
name. She went to Europe. Where'd she go?
Israel. Mind your business.
Mind your business. That's kind of a strong statement.
Mind your business. Okay. Mind your business. Real talk. Mind your business. Like, if you're not going out there to make it better over there, do something. Make a change. Make a difference.
Yes.
If you're not going over there for that, you're just talking about, I just want to come and see for myself what it is, because I don't believe social media.
On my way to Tel Aviv, then to Jerusalem, then I'm going to the Dead Sea and go and get me some. Gonna have some fun, yeah, it's gonna be great. Then I'm gonna learn about the politics, hey. See, I feel like I can't believe everything I see on the internet. I can't believe everything everybody's saying to me on the internet. I need to go see for myself. I'm one of those people.
What? So you put yourself in the middle of a war to be nosy? To pull the curtain back and say, oh, look.
No, because if she gets hit with a missile, then she's going to know what it is. That's all.
Yeah, if she gets hit with a missile, but
She said she's going to Israel, then she's going somewhere else.
See what I'm saying? Now you're switching sides. Her.
Okay,
because now she's switching sides. Like, you want to be in Israel, and you want to be with the people over there, like, oh, I sympathize for what y'all going through. Then you want to go to the other side and be like, oh, I sympathize with what y'all going through. What are you doing? So you're not making a difference. You're just being nosy.
So she could sympathize with just one people? Let me understand this. I don't know.
But my thing is, go out there and make a change. Go out there and make a difference. Mm-hmm. If you're not going out there for none of that, what are you going out there for? Because you don't believe social media? Half of us don't believe social media. But we're not going to stick our neck out there in the war. No, it's a war going on. Why am I going to throw myself?
Somebody had a song like that. What was the...
There's a war going on outside. No man is safe from.
There's a war going on outside. No man is safe from. Could run, but you can't hide forever from these streets that we done took.
You walking with your head down, scared to look.
Yeah. You can run, but you can't.
And I mean, look, I'm going to be honest with you. The United States is some nosy motherfuckers. Right. And eventually, World War III is coming. Because I ain't going to hold you. I don't know if everybody's been aware of what's going on. But the other day, people's phones was crazy. Nobody could take, receive calls, text.
AT&T,
Verizon, and T-Mobile. All three of them. At a certain point. Yeah.
That's crazy.
If you have an AT&T cell phone plan and your phone's not working, you're not alone.
Yeah, customers across the country appear to be experiencing some sort of crazy outage. Customers are taking to social media saying they cannot make or receive phone calls. Users with new model iPhones are getting an SOS, meaning cellular connection is not working, but of course the Wi-Fi is. Older models are seeing a no service indicator. The problem is not clear at this time. There are also reports of Verizon and T-Mobile. They are experiencing some of these outages as well.
So, how do we know that that wasn't done purposely? We don't know that.
People rely too much on technology. Like, y'all rely too much on technology, banks, all this. All this stuff can crash just like this.
Like how?
Like this. Like, yeah. It's machines. Machines. Y'all rely too much on machines. And say, oh, machines is going to take over for the humans and there's not going to be no more jobs. Yeah, but y'all should be scared about that.
Now,
all
you know what?
AI and machines.
Yeah, I agree with that because I'm not going to hold you. Anytime I call somewhere and it's like an AI automated thing, they piss me off. Because I got to ask the same thing and keep saying the same thing. That's why I always tell them, I don't want to talk to you. And they say, well, can I help you? No. And can I get you something? No. I don't want to talk to a robot. If I got to get cursed out, let me get cursed out by a human. Because the human gives me an opportunity to curse him back. The robot doesn't say anything and they just hang up and I don't like that. Give me an opportunity to be able to express myself. It's not cool that you be able to tell me what you want, but I can't tell you what I want. Like him.
Let's get back to sneakers real quick, though.
Yes, sneakers.
You're a sneakerhead, no?
Yes.
So?
No. I won't purchase them. I won't purchase them.
Good. I don't want you to purchase them.
Kind of the style.
What's up with Jordans?
What's up with them?
The same Jordan comes out every single year. The same. They don't remake it. They don't change a color, nothing. It could be the same sneaker every single year. Oh, the re-release of such and such. And they sell it for $300, $400.
Like that. That's what you did? Like that.
Every year. Just like that. Mm-hmm. And every single year, people going by the same sneaker. Why don't you just keep the sneaker clean from the previous year?
Now, that's so what you're supposed to do. When you're supposed to keep them in a box.
There you go.
Nice and clean. And then when it's time for the new one to come out, you sell your old one, which is considered an OG. And then you go ahead and go get more money for
there
it.
There you go. I know he's a sneakerhead. Because when anything gets re-released, he got him on his feet already from when he had. This is what I'm saying. Why are y'all wasting your money out here? Salute to Jordan.
Hold on. You can't knock nobody hustle now. If that's your hustle. Keep doing what you're doing. One being hustled, that's on you. Look, we do a weekly show, right? And they come back every week to watch and hear the shit that me and you say, which is, from what I've been told, a lot of people think this is a very funny show. And now what we want is, let's get some sponsors. Let's get somebody to give us some money. Don't you think we could do that? Let's talk to a sponsor right now. Who you think should sponsor the show besides Sweetleaf? Because Sweetleaf sponsors us, so we're very grateful for that.
Raw Rolling Papers.
So reach out to Raw,
Raw Rolling Papers.
And let's get a sponsorship. Give us something. Give us some merch. Give us something. Come on. Goddamn. Oh, and shout out to the boy Chuck. Man, I spoke to the boy Chuck yesterday. Man, that Cookies brand. Do remember, they out there and they doing some things. What else was, we was in the background discussing, because he says we never have topics to talk about.
Mayor Adams. What's wrong with you? I just got a bone to pick with a lot of people.
What does that mean? Can you explain that to me? A bone to pick. What does that actually mean? Because people that are watching this, they may not know what that means. What does it mean?
I got a gripe with you.
Like, what does that mean?
Problem. I have a problem with you, Mayor Adams.
Mayor Adams. Show him. This is Mayor Adams right here. Put him in between. That's Mayor Adams right there.
First, you want to give these migrants all this money, right?
I have a problem with that myself.
You want to give them money? Oh, we living bad. The ones that's been here. We living bad. We could use some of that. But the migrants that come here, you want to give them all this money, right? Now, You want to limit them. Now you want to take the money from them and limit them like $13 a day or something like that, just for food and monetize.
Now, where the fuck you going to get food for $13 a day?
This is what I'm saying.
Shout out to Halal. So you get a good plate of Halal for $13.
So now you're trying to monitor their bread.
That's actually 8 with water's 10, but okay.
Now you're trying to monitor their bread.
Yesterday on Fox 5, the mayor was also asked questions about the controversial prepaid debit card plan for 500 migrant families. The city issued a $53 million no-bid contract to a firm to help administer this pilot program. The mayor says migrants will be given $13 a day for food and baby products.
It's supposed to go to only food and baby supplies. If it's abused, we would take those cards away.
So the mayor was also asked how the city plan on keeping tabs on migrants to ensure that the money doesn't go to other things besides food and baby products. The mayor didn't have a clear answer on that, but he says if this program is successful, then they plan on expanding it to even more migrant families.
What you think they're going to do?
So hold on, where's the rest of the money going?
This is what I'm saying.
I need to be a part of y'all game. The way y'all got this game fixed, it's one hell of a game. So you get to give people money. Then when the money's there, you take it away. Where does the rest go?
And that, and also,
I need to be a part of that. Damn.
What you think they're going to do when they need money? What you think they're going to do?
They're going to keep robbing people like they've been doing. Like I told y'all last week. Look, you either going to do good.
Don't say it again.
Go get a job and figure out life. Or go do bad. One or the other, but just don't sit around and do nothing. See, people have an issue with the nothing guy. The nothing guy, you're doing nothing. We don't like, do something, good or bad. It doesn't matter. So for the migrants, they did some, you know, they beat the cop up. That was crazy. Now I ain't going to hold you.
They're doing a lot.
For us that were born here and been here for a long time, we do that, we're getting shot. What
this
happened
what
to
I'm
the stun
saying.
Gun?
This is
the
what
cop,
I'm saying.
There was no
this
maze,
is what
nothing?
I'm saying. I look at a cop wrong, and I might get busted up. They jumped dead in the middle of Times Square. You get locked up, they let them go. Where they let them go? Back to where they live in hotels. They living
first
in these five-star hotels.
All, you're letting a person go where? Where are they going? They don't have an address.
No, some of these people live, some of these migrants live in five-star hotels for real. Like, they live in, like, they
sheltered. So I can be a migrant.
I'm trying to tell you, man. They're living better than us, bro.
Well,
they're living better than us,
look,
bro.
Next week, we're doing a migrant show. Me and G will become migrants next week. And we're going to figure this out. They get free health. You get I need a brand new Social Security so I can start from scratch. I'm going to start that. I think I might have to put that together. Just wipe everything away that's been done in the past. If I owe y'all some money,
that don't sound too bad.
Right? Let's start from scratch.
I think it's illegal.
You get the noise.
I think it's called jail time.
No, it's not. How?
A whole new social, a whole new identity.
Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to fly to Mexico, and I'm going to walk back. So once I hop over the little gate, then I'm a brand new me. I'm no longer who I was when I left. So now,
it's just that simple. Hop over the little gate. You're just going to hop over the little
gate. That's how they do it. Somebody got that plug, and I'm going to get with them. Yo, when I get to Mexico, shout out to all my Mexicans. Just show me the way to get back over here, and then I'm going to start from scratch.
How they get here?
That, some way. I don't know. I ain't got nothing to do with that. But I'm going to get back, and then what name would you take? I'm going to get a new name. I don't know what I – what name would you – want you – if we have to scratch – we're going to start from scratch. What name would you want?
Pablo.
Damn. You don't look like a Pablo, but fuck it. You know what? I think I'm going to go with – let me see. Seth. Going all the way white.
Okay, so I don't look like a Pablo.
S-E-T-H, Seth.
All right, so I don't look like a Pablo, but you look like a Seth.
Seth, first of all. Yeah, I think I could pull it off. You know, why not? You don't think I look like a Seth? Check the side profile. No, it's the side profile.
You know what? You kind of looking Sethish.
See what I'm saying? See? So now, from now on.
Let me see the other side. Nah, you still see.
Fuck. Yeah. Look, ladies and gentlemen, when you see me now, call me Seth. I'm new. I'm going to get a new Social Security card, and I'm going to get a new birth certificate, and my name going to be Seth. And I'm going to live in a migrant hotel. All you got to do is walk back from Mexico. This is not that difficult.
All right, when you get the hookup, you let me know. Me and my whole family. Fuck it, we ball.
Yeah, let's just start from scratch. Y'all, you know what it is?
Live off the city.
Yeah, y'all making this too difficult, y'all. Y'all want to fight? Don't fight. Just join the system. Go with the game. Go to Mexico and walk back. You're brand new. So if you got any bills, you owe anybody some money, go, come back, start from scratch. And they give you, what is it, $30,000? It's not a bad move, man.
I told you they cutting the money, man. They cutting the money.
See, the so 13 a day. Well, they 13 cut, they a day
I think it's like $13 a day now, like something like that
it's
now.
It's not too much money.
But I'm saying you're going to have a lot of mad migrants, and they just going to be out here looting. And they you could tell they already don't care about the law. So, like, oh, my goodness. Never mind.
No,
I'm just frustrated, man. Like, so many of us need that. So many of us could use that. There's so many homeless people that's been here for so long.
Now, I heard that some of the homeless people don't want to get taken care of. That's what they said. Like, they tell them, yo, you can go here, we can go there, we can get you some food, and they say no. Now, why they say no, I have no idea. Because you can't give me that option. I'd be the flyest homeless person you ever see.
I'm right there with you.
I'd be right with the migrants. I don't speak no English, too. Huh? Como? Dímelo. I'll be right to it. Right back. What are you talking about? We get right to it and understand nothing. Sign language. I do all of that. I know how to do sign language.
Sign language. All that.
And then if everything goes wrong, just one. This sign language always works. Bang. Oh. Always. It's something that's
universal.
Go
it's universal. Anybody knows
for
that.
Life. Let's talk about. Now, let's analyze this. At the end of the day, we're about to have another presidential thing going on. And here's my question of life. Have we gotten this bad that we have to have? Biden don't even know where the fuck he's at. I'm going to just be honest with you. He's way too old to be making a decision for like a six-year-old kid.
Yeah,
they're so far apart, it doesn't even make sense.
We need an AI at this point.
And then you're going to have Trump in there who he don't even know. He lies so much, he don't even know the last lie that he told. He gets so caught up. I ain't going to lie. Shout out to the New York boy. The New York judge said, you know what? You want to have to sell some property or give me some money because I ain't going for none of that. I need my money yesterday. Yeah. New York don't play that. You know that. Everybody else going to give him a pass. But why don't we get a young president?
I don't know. You said everybody else might give him a pass, but here. But if you look at this clip.
If you look at what's happened in New York, I'm not even blaming the mayor. I think the mayor has sort of been told to take a back seat a little bit because they came after him violently. And so I'm not blaming him. I'm just saying we have 500,000 migrants, illegal migrants in New York on Madison Avenue. They're sleeping on Madison Avenue. They're sleeping on Fifth Avenue. It's horrible what's going on. I think there's a chance to win New York. The people are very, very unhappy.
He said I'm predicting that we're going to win New York because of what we just talked about, the migrant situation. He was like, because he was the one keeping the migrants out. He was like, I was keeping them out.
Well, yeah, yeah.
He was like, now y'all let them in, and now y'all want me back.
No, I don't know about that, but let's give him credit.
He said New York wants him back.
You got to give him credit where credit is due. He definitely had, he said he was going to build a wall that was never built. Let's just be honest. Yeah. Now, what we also can say is when COVID hit, he fucked up because he said it wasn't really that serious. And a lot of people died. So if he'd have jumped on it beforehand, them people might still be here.
You know what? Being a president is hard anyway. I don't it, Trump or for anybody because 4 years in office, that's what they get, right? Four years in office is not long enough to clean up the other president's mess.
Well, I don't understand this. And somebody explain this to me because, again, I'm just asking a question. I don't know. So just tell me what the fuck goes on. I don't understand the division between blue and red. So basically, Crips and Bloods.
Right.
At some point, if we're working together, shouldn't we come to a table? Because they tell people to act like an adult. That's what they tell you when you're growing up. When you get to a certain age, you should act like an adult. Okay.
Adult guys.
So now, if you're sitting on one side of the table, I'm sitting on the other side of the table. If we're discussing, let's say, hunger, it's really not that fucking difficult to understand feed and feed. Now, why are we arguing over who gets fed more or first? That's a question that you have to ask yourself.
But then there goes the red and the blue part, because you know, the red.
Are you a Are you a Democrat or a Republican?
I'm not from here.
Here we go with this bullshit again.
I'm not from here, but since I'm here,
okay,
and I have to blend in with you, humans.
Yes.
I'm a Democrat.
You're a Democrat. Yeah. Okay.
You know what I mean, I'm doing it for my people. I'm with my people.
There we go. Now you're saying that your people are all Democratic?
Because
I can't. Once again, we can't. It's blue and it's red, and sometimes you'd be surprised of who's red. Now, when you say a Democrat,
that is true.
When you say you're a Democrat, what do you feel is democratic about you, about yourself?
I'm middle class. I'm considered middle class.
There is no such thing. Today is rich or poor. There is no middle class.
Oh, so damn. I'm poor.
Okay, cool.
So the poor people are Democratic. Okay. For most of the poor people are Democratic. I mean, it's just
now,
facts.
Now, do you feel, because, see, now I gotta argue with the Democrat thing, because you just said that you feel a certain way about the migrants being taken care of, and it's just not a third, and you expect you to get taken care of because you're from here. That's not the Democratic way. That's the Republican way. Republicans believe this here first, everything else second.
No.
Go look it up.
No. I'm talking about, if you can take care of them, why are you not taking care of the people, exactly, the people that was here first?
But what I'm trying to tell you is the Republican way is, as your man Trump, everything here, everything for here, everything for the United States first, and fuck everybody else till after. That's what he says. That's okay. That's the Republican way. And then the Democratic way is, let's just give to everybody. But mind you, they're not helping the people that are here for them.
But they're not giving to everybody.
So once again, are you Democratic or are you Republican now? Think about it. So I'm trying to tell you, man. Me, I'm going to say this, ladies and gentlemen. When y'all go vote, I've been voting for myself for the last who knows how many. I need somebody else. I need to go when I look at it.
I don't
know
if you could really say that on camera. I don't really know if you could tell the people you've been voting for yourself. I don't think you can do that.
I have been voting for myself. What the fuck can I do?
You're not on nothing. You're not
on crazy when that ballot sees. I'm not going to say my last name here because I don't even know who the fuck's happening. Y'all might steal my identity because that's what's going on a lot. But just C's. Just put C's there. Right. C-E-A-S. I'm there. No E. Right. Help me out. Come on now. Right. Damn. Oh, new music is out, by the way. Shout out to the boy French Montana. Oh. He dropped and it's go check it out. Go get it. Absolutely. Show a little clip of the video. Got a little video that's out. Kind of dope.
Absolutely.
What else is going on? Because he said we don't have no topics.
Man.
And
I don't know, man.
I know your man Trump posted something about Biden going to the nursing home.
As for a special caring touch, visiting angels care so much. Visiting angels, America's choice in home care.
That was funny.
He needs to.
He's very old. We need a young president. What are the chances? Well, that's not going to happen now, but. Why can't we? The United States of America needs somebody about 40 years old to run the country. 40. That's, you're almost at the middle. You could relate to these dummies and you could relate to those kids.
I don't know. 40? I don't know. I think you need a couple more years.
Nah. Matter of fact, I think I should be able to. I could run. Y'all hit the email. Hit the email. Tell me what y'all want me to change. Because I can change a lot of things for y'all.
Like what? Like what would be your first thing you would change? Like, I'm just interested because maybe I want to vote for you. So tell them what would be the first thing. You know, like when the president be like, I would like to change.
I'm going to give y'all clean water. Water's dirty right now. Water's not too good. I'm going to give y'all clean water. I'm going to clean up the sewer system.
You sound like every other president, because how are you going to do that? How are you just going to clean up the sewer
system? So you know what? Let me do it backwards. The whole sewer system? All right. So you know what? I'm going to be an honest president. I think a lot of the presidents that come out, they lie. So I'm going to raise the taxes, y'all. I'm going to raise taxes. Because I need to be a nicer boat, and I need to be able to vacation. Me and the wife be able to go everywhere. Me and the kids, splurge, the grandkids. See, so I'm going to raise taxes. And if you owe school money, I'm going to make sure that you pay penalties if you don't pay it back. That's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to cut jobs. I'm going to cut mad jobs. Yep. That's what I'm going to do.
So you trying to win?
Yeah. I'm being honest. I'm just being honest. I'm coming to you and I'm saying to you, here the cards. This is how we're going to play. That's it. So I'm not lying. I'm not lying. So if you do vote for me, you at least know he told us he was going to do that. I'm firing at least 7 people when I get in office. Like, people that work for me, you're out of here.
Usually people lie about light stuff. You're lying, like, about huge stuff that won't get
this
you.
This is
like,
what's happening
you're
anyway.
Not, you're not going. You're they not tell going you to the White House they're gonna,
why not?
You're not, because not? That was just too honest.
Like, and we're going to war immediately. You know me, guys. Off the gate. Kaboom. Let's go. Let's get to it. We ain't going to be doing all of this hugging and that. Nah. Let's get right to it. I'm going to places, even if you ain't got no beef with us, I'm you too. Because at this point, what are we holding all the for? What do we have this big army, the biggest army in the world? We're the strongest, we're the best. We ain't nobody trying it. Let's try it. Let's see what this is all about. Why not? Something that ain't got nothing to do with us, you know, just wipe that away. Everybody else is doing it. They just wiping things away. So what's the difference? I'm coming in, I'm telling you, we're going to war. I come in, what is it, January 1st? January 2nd, get ready.
We, first movie vibe.
And I need people out in the front. Even if you, like, once again, if you're doing nothing at home, I'm coming to get you. You on the front lines. What are we losing if we lose them? What are we losing? Yeah. Nothing at all.
You need a hug?
No.
You okay?
Yes. I want to be the president of the United States. That's
did,
what I want.
Did you eat today?
Definitely. Definitely.
Did you smoke?
I don't smoke. I don't smoke, ladies and gentlemen.
So this is mine? You rolled this for me?
Once again, how do you say that I rolled something? This camera thing gets people to say a lot of things,
you
man.
You could roll. You could roll without smoking.
Shout
did
out
you
to
roll, you rolled. You rolled.
Shout out to the sponsors, man. Once again.
So is that mine?
I don't know what you speak of. The lighter
this,
you could use.
This in the ashtray. This right here.
Then why would you keep using
this? This right here. This.
I have no. I don't even know what right that is. That's a cigar. This is a cigar.
Okay, so is it my cigar?
This is a cigar. I smoke cigars. I smoke small cigars. That's what I smoke. Pause. So, you know. But, back to sports. The NBA's back. Did you know the NBA's back? They came off of All-Star. Do you,
I don't watch All-Star.
Yeah, I can't even talk to them. You don't even know who won.
Yeah, the East. The East.
So you say you were. How are your Knicks doing, Mr. Knicks fan?
We in there. We hanging in there.
Hanging in there. What was the last? They just came back. Did y'all win that game? Y'all played Philly.
Nah.
Y'all didn't win that game against Philly?
No.
Yeah, see that? No. They did win.
Yeah. Oh, somebody gave me the wrong information because I ain't see the game. So somebody told me wrong, I guess, to get under my skin. You know, but yeah. Okay.
Once again, shout out to the Lakers. We lost. We made no trades during the trade.
Why still hang with them if they lose?
Because I'm a Laker fan till I go. That's my team.
You're a Lakers fan?
Yeah, I'm not a person like you who says, you know, I just come around for a minute and then I leave. Because just 2 seconds ago, you was gone from the Knicks. You said I'm not.
So what do you think about the Lakers saying they'll draft LeBron's son just to keep him? How you feel about that?
I haven't really seen LeBron's son play, so I couldn't tell you.
Wow.
If he's any good, then why not?
Nah, he gets busy. But the deal is, in order to keep me, y'all have to draft my son. Like, that's dope of Shaq, but you think he's that?
Dope of Shaq.
Yeah, that's dope of him to say that for his son. Like, bring my son in on the Lakers. Yeah, that's dope as a father. Facts. But for the
You're
Lakers,
saying
I'm
Shaq.
Like,
what the fuck does Shaq have to do?
My bad.
That Sweet Leaves is amazing. Because I'm like, Shaq, you stopped playing with us a long time ago.
My bad, bro.
If you're bringing your son, so my, fucking be it, Shaq.
I'm high. Okay, that's dope with LeBron, but still, like, as the Lakers, like, I don't think I care for a player that much.
Again,
if I don't want your son, I don't want your son.
If the kid is good enough, then bring him. If he's good enough, if he's not, then he won't.
Well,
make
I mean
the cut.
To play on the Lakers, yeah, wow. He's good. He's good to play on the Lakers.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, we'll take all darts. We take them, no problem. We don't have an
That's
issue
not
with
a
them.
Dart. I said he's good to play on the Lakers.
I'm here to tell you.
Depending
y'all,
on how you feel about your team.
We'll come back. Just remember this face with the ashtray on it.
Now I got an ashtray.
That he will now later say that he's no longer a Knicks fan. Remember I said this to y'all. Okay, I'm going to be a Laker fan no matter what. Whether we get in the playoffs or not, I'm still a Laker fan.
I've been left the Knicks alone. See I told you I left them alone like 2 episodes ago when they lost. When they was on their 6-game streak and then they lost.
It was actually 9.
9-game streak and they lost to your team.
Say it one more time.
They See lost that? To your team.
See how we get them
that was time. That was the day that me and them parted ways. I'm not trying to go through this. I'm not trying to go through the sympathy that they be putting their fans through. Like, the whole slogan, better luck next time, maybe next year. Like, I don't do those slogans. I roll with the winners.
Nice. So who you going to go with now, then?
Gotta watch a couple more games and see who ride.
Look, damn all of that. Shout out to the boy Pop, you know, that boxing thing he was talking about. Didn't one of these fighters just agree to fight? There's a fight that somebody agreed upon it. I don't know who. I really don't.
I think it was a Tank. I think it was an offer that was given from Tank to fight somebody, but I don't remember the other person.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure it flashed on the screen, though. But, yeah.
Well, you went and did your research and then put it up there.
That's usually
very
how
smart.
Editing works.
Oh, and by the way, look, I don't know if y'all been paying attention, right? But send us a video, and if we like it, we'll play it at the end of the show. Because that's what he's been doing.
Yeah, for sure.
And I know
for
you sure, sent me you sent me a young lady that you said, you know, I've seen you post a bit on your gram.
And
who
you
is
know
this?
You know what's crazy? Who shined the spotlight on her? Chuck. You was just bigging Chuck up early.
Yes.
Chuck
shout out to the boy Chuck.
Yeah, Chuck brought her to the spotlight. He said his brother was dealing with an artist. And she was trying to do her whole package, you know, videos and all that. She was ready to go. She worked with a couple of artists. She wrote for a couple of artists, and she's ready to go with her own music. And she has like a 7-song EP that she's trying to put out. So, you know, Project Media, salute to Lloyd, salute to Shreddy. Know what I mean? Project Media is on the job. Nice.
She's shout out singer. To the boy Lloyd. Matter of fact, Lloyd did this mini movie that we put out not too long ago. You know, show a little clip right here. Get the stash like a Mario.
It's the summertime. AC's on and the windows up. All my family pulling up. 'Cause ain't no doubt about it. It's the summertime.
Oh God.
I mean, if you want your video to look like that, hit this email and he'll make it happen. Yeah. And for 10%, you know, I told y'all for $19.99, man, I'm going to show you how to get some. But nobody wants to pay no attention to me, man. I'm going to teach y'all how to be holy. Your holiness will understand how to get money for $19.95.
Open up your phone, man. What's some more topics?
Ain't there nothing be some else more in topics. Here. There's nothing else
open
in
up
here.
The phone.
What else is there? What oh, the lady. Miss? There was a girl that had her daughter waxing. She would say she had a waxing. The lady, Miss... What? What the fuck is wrong with you?
What are you talking about?
She
what?
Was waxing the poo-poo.
Oh, you're talking about the little kid. Yeah. There's just some jobs that you're not supposed to teach your kids. Like, if you want to teach your kids how to wash dishes early, cool. Well, hey, sweep, how to clean their room, clean up after the dog, you know, stuff like that. Not how to wax. And, like, the girl was the what, like, 7 years old?
Hold on, we're gonna be adults not to wax vagina. I know you ladies feel bad about us saying the word, so we're gonna say vagina, okay?
Right.
So, vagina. But, now, let me ask you a question.
JJ.
When the girls, when the ladies out the suit, when they go to the gynecologist, they're usually female gynecologists, right? They're not male. Because it would be kind of, like, for instance, could you imagine, you're a, hey, I'm just asking. You're a gynecologist and you walk in a room and her legs is like this.
Nah, there's male GYNs.
So now if you're a male GYN, now here's my question. When you practice, right, and let's be honest here. You walk in the joint and shorty legs is like this.
Right.
And
bingo, I got action.
He's looking right at you. You and her, too, bing, bing, right there. When you go in there, you do the hammer go woo, or do you got to be a professional? So does the hammer stay down, or does the hammer come up?
You want to know something? You checking so many.
Nah, there's no way.
You're checking so many, you just don't get turned on no more.
Your hammer's
like,
dead.
So many. I'm like this, it's your job.
I'm like this the whole day. There's no way. There's no way possible.
You can't do that at your job.
Are you crazy? Are you looking at joints? All day.
No.
Look, I'm gonna tell you. Shout out to all of the male gynecologists. No, you have one. Your skill is amazing.
You can't do that.
That's. But the way when you is there a certain way to touch? Do you like lift it? Do you twirl? Like what do you do? And how do you know now? Let me ask you another question. If it's nice, you like wow. How about the ones that come in as foul? Like with the ones that come in and they woo.
If you have a mask on, you might not be able to smell.
Nah, you still smell it. Some of them is just wrong. And why does it smell like? What is wrong, ladies? No, water. No. You got to drink water. Water is the key to a lot of things, man. Water and apricot. I heard if you eat a lot of apricots, you'll be okay.
Okay.
I'm just telling them. I'm trying to work and help y'all out. I'm not here to do nothing wrong. Mm. I'm here to tell. Once again, for $19.95, man.
Hold on. $19.95, you said you was selling holiness.
This
you
is holiness. Said, I can make you a holy person.
Telling
you
people could, how to check is whole
and
vagina.
Smell. And smell. And you do.
And talking smells. About vagina and telling them how to check vagina is not holiness.
Are
There's
you
nothing
kidding
holy
me?
About that. There's nothing holy about talking about.
The big
hey,
man put us, if he put
like,
us here. No, he didn't put us here for that smell. He didn't do that. Because if you drink a lot of water, which he put a lot of here, you'd smell very natural, very fresh. And you have to wash.
I'm pretty sure in the Book of Holiness, there's not a chapter that... how many pages is your book?
Depends. I have one for like 64 pages. And then I have...
Hold on. You just have one for... there's a series.
Absolutely. Def, what you think is going on here?
Wait.
1995. Hit 1995, the email.
They just get the one book, though. They don't get the 64, other books?
That's just no way. That's the 64-chapter book you get for 1995.
64 chapters?
No, 64 pages in 60, that one chapter.
Okay, so which... And they're all, but they're all the Book of Holiness.
Yes. Caesar's holiness. This is my holiness.
So
nobody
which,
else.
Which book or which chapter does it talk about checking vagina? Like,
I think that's in the third chapter.
Yes, so that's in the first book, probably.
No, it's not in the first book. It's a mention, but I don't really get into too much detail. If you want detail, it's in chapter 3 or 4. Okay. Yeah, I got Power series 17 and 18, all these other, but I'm wrong for doing what I do. I don't understand.
Yeah, because Power has structure. So the structure of Power is like, you know, all the criminal stuff that's going on, like you Kanan and this, that, and the third ghost. You're talking about holiness.
Yes.
Right? And then you're talking about...
No, but that you gotta, because you gotta check the situation. You gotta check the situation out. You gotta go in there, because this situation is gonna birth other situations. And you don't wanna come out of there unholy. I'm gonna show you how you can make a holy baby. Holiness.
Where did we get to making babies from the gynecologist? What's going on here?
Because he preps it. I think that's more like prep. You know how when you cook, you gotta prep your food? I think what the gynecologist does is he preps the situation for you, he makes it nice and secure. Ladies, start going a little bit more to the gynecologist. Get checked out. Make sure everything's running right. Make sure all your waters is flowing right. Everything's good. Your hoses is right. Everything. You got to make sure that everything's good in there. Everything. Because you too, one day, can be holy. And I pick my holiness through,
okay,
you know.
Good topic. So you telling the ladies, make sure this is right. Make sure that's right.
I said the words that I wanted to say. Don't make...
So listen, but, right, do you think it's necessary for the men, if they feel like the woman should do this and the woman should do that, because there's a lot of men out there that feel like women should do this.
Men should wash their balls too and wash yourself. Okay, a lot of y'all smell like ass. A lot of y'all.
Because, you know, there's like a lot of men like, you know, okay, let's just say me, right?
Like, you smell like ass? Like,
no, we're not talking about hygiene.
You just said
no
me,
more.
So I'm
no,
like,
no,
what
I'm,
the fuck?
I'm giving an example of something else. We're not talking about hygiene no more. Okay. We're talking about like preference, right? Mm-hmm. So now, is men like me? I got a foot fetish.
You ever men? So you said this twice now.
So I expect for women to have nice feet.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? But so I'm not going to expect for a woman to have nice feet and then I don't. You see what I'm saying? But there's a lot of dudes that...
Well, nobody gives a fuck about your feet. That's the whole problem. You care about your feet.
No,
that's the whole situation.
But I'm saying that's
the... Hold on. But whoa. So you want a girl to have nice feet, but her situation ain't situation?
No, of course. I've said, but number one on my list is hygiene. I said that before. Like, they already know who I am. Listen, but I'm saying...
So now let me ask you a question. Shorty bad. She bananas. Feet incredible.
Now,
nice
hygiene
white
is off.
No. Hygiene is rocking. Everything's good. But the poom poom, wild hairy. Under her arms, wild hairy. But she bananas. She smells good. Feet look beautiful, everything.
Oh, she got the natural growing.
Yeah, the natural hair.
No,
she got like
I don't like the natural growing. Like, once I hit that mark,
I just want to know why you did this and look down at yourself.
Yeah,
that
like, I don't like
sense,
the natural growing because that's where their vagina would be. So it's like, I don't like the natural growing.
So if
growing.
She's bananas, you're going to literally, and when I say literally, not mess with her because she has long hair?
Good. There's called turnoffs, right? Uh-huh. There's like switches that'll turn you off. That's just like a woman being bad as hell and being, again, that I'm into feet. She has some messed up
I just
feet.
Told you her feet are beautiful. Thing. Everything.
I know, but now she has the Harry the Hendersons, the Sasquatch,
no,
in her,
but,
in
but
between
she,
her legs
no, but
and
she
under
trims
her
it. She trims it and under here.
I
she
don't care if
you're
styling an afro. It's still an afro. What are you styling? You can style. You. What do you... What? She got to have a... She can have a landing strip. She got a little one
no,
of those.
No, she has a whole jizz on. Bang, a whole...
She got like... She don't have a landing strip. She got
no,
a whole
she has
island.
A whole...
She
has
a whole
airport.
Island.
There's the whole airport.
Whole airport.
Ain't
no,
just nah,
we not... No.
Mad gates.
Not no fly zone.
Well, that's messed up, ladies. Look, this is a person right here that would be judgmental towards you. But if you, for $19.99, can get, I will show you how to get away from this type of person with your holiness. And you can still have a whole bunch of joint, hair under your arm, through, as long as you're clean. Cleansiness is next to godliness, and we know I am the holy one. So I can teach you these things.
Let me tell you something. Under your arms, sweat constantly. You can never be clean under your arms with an afro up under there. Like, you can never be clean. If you have the natural
good deodorant under there, you good.
That's even worse. Anything caught up in your hairs is going to go
now all some of type a sudden of he's a scientist. Like, now he knows no, the hair just, getting caught
just
under
real,
this.
It's just real situations. Like, it's just real situations. Like, you can't go throughout the day without sweating, and what then you got hair under there.
What does this mean?
Because you're rubbing your arms together, like with your afro. Like that, oh, no, you can't do that.
So you wouldn't. So you're saying no. Just say no.
Yeah, I've been said no.
Okay, you now have to give an explanation. Ladies, 1999, I'll fix that for you.
Nobody wants that book. None of them books. And it's not going to teach you no holiness. You're not holy. None of this is holy. Like matter of fact, I'm getting the holy fuck up out of here. Cause
man, you know what? Ladies and gentlemen, the disrespect and being the negativity, that you don't smoke, and it all happens from the people that you know. So guess what I'm going to do?
I'm out of here.
Well, good. I'm glad he left. You know why? Because I'm going to tell you, 1999, hit the email. Your holy one will get to you and teach you holiness. Thank you for coming out. God bless you, and good night.